Good morning, my dear students. We are studying second unit, that is balance of payment. And in this video, we are going to study third subtitle, which is called as disequilibrium and causes for disequilibrium in balance of payment. When we say disequilibrium in balance of payment, there are two possibilities in balance of payment. One, balance of payment can be surplus, or balance of payment can be deficit. When we say balance of payment is surplus, it means receipts are greater than payments. And if we say deficit in balance of payment, it means receipts are less than the payments. So with this background, we shall try to study causes for disequilibrium in balance of payment. There are many causes responsible for disequilibrium in balance of payment, and we have selected few important factors which have great impact and influence on disequilibrium in the balance of payment. The first one is quantitative changes. Now look at this particular screen. It speaks, a change in the quantity included in the balance of payment is likely to cause disequilibrium. Meaning is that whatever quantities we are importing and exporting, if there is any change in these imports and export quantities, that will definitely cause disequilibrium in the balance of payment. Balance of payment, either it will be surplus or it will be deficit. Now, these changes may arise on account of variety of reasons. If there is any change in quantity imported and exported, it may occur on account of n number of forces or n number of factors. The changes in demand and supply conditions cause change in the quantity imported and exported. Here I have taken one simple example to explain how a change in the quantity imported and exported leads to disequilibrium in the balance of payment. There is a table having three columns. First column is years, next column quantity export of rice in quintals, then third column quantity imported, a quantity import of wheat in quintals. In the year 2020, the quantity export of rice in quintal was 1000 and quantity of import of wheat in quintal was 1000. In 2020, quantity of exports were equal to quantity of imports. The balance of payment was balanced. In fact, this is balance of trade. Now in the year 2021, quantity exported is 1000 and quantity imported is 1200. What is the meaning? Our receipts are less than payments. This is an example of deficit in the balance of payment. This is how change in the quantity imported and exported leads to disequilibrium. Specifically, here we have taken example of deficit in the balance of payment. So this is one of the main reasons that any change in the quantity imported and exported leads to disequilibrium in the balance of payment. In next slide, we are having another important cause for disequilibrium in the balance of payment, that is changes in the price cost structure. What is the meaning? If there is any change in the price and cost structure of goods imported and exported, that will lead to disequilibrium in the balance of payment. This is qualitative aspect of balance of payment. And the previous cause which we have discussed is quantitative aspect of balance of payment. I will read this slide for your understanding. The balance of payment position is also affected by changes in the price cost structure of exports or also imports. The changes in wages, higher prices of raw materials and other requirements will affect price cost structure and exports. If there is, in simple language, if there is any change in the prices of goods and services, or if there is any change in the cost of production of goods and services, that will definitely have impact on exports and also imports. Here I have taken one simple example to explain how price cost structure brings about change in exports and imports of the country. We will have to assume that domestic prices increase. When domestic prices increase, what will be the impact of this? The next impact is that the domestic products will be unattractive to the foreigners, number one. When prices of domestic goods and services increases, these goods and services will be unattractive to the foreigners. Meaning is that foreign demand for our domestic goods and services will come down. Exports will come down. This is number one. The second impact of this particular change. If domestic prices increase, then our own country people may not buy our own goods and services because the prices increased. Instead of buying domestic goods and services, they will buy foreign goods and services whose prices have not changed. Now, in second impact, the imports have increased. In first impact, exports have come down, and this leads to disequilibrium in the balance of payment. So, domestic prices may increase on account of increase in the wages of the laborers, increase in the price of raw materials, and changes in many other things. So prices will get influenced and that will affect the exports. So this is how change in the price cost structure will affect the balance of payment position. It will lead to disequilibrium in the balance of payment. We have taken the example of how deficit in the balance of payment results on account of change in the price and cost structure at domestic level. After studying this, in next slide we are going to study the third cause for disequilibrium in the balance of payment. What is that? Change in the national income. I will read this slide for you. Another important factor that influences the balance of payment position is fluctuations in national income. The demand and supply conditions of exports and imports will be influenced by changes in the national income through per capita income and the level of consumption. I have a simple example. The example is that if national income of our country increases, what will be the next impact of this? It will lead to increase in per capita income and level of consumption. Thereby, Indians may buy more of foreign goods and less of domestic goods because of improvement in the standard of living. This will lead to increase in imports and decline in exports. Thus, it will result in deficit in the balance of payment. This is how an increase in national income will encourage imports of goods and services. But this may not be true in case of developed countries. in developed countries, though national income is increasing, though per capita income of the people is increasing, though standard of living of the people is increasing, but in their cases, imports are not increasing because of increased national income. Because the quality of their goods and services produced in their own country is much better. And thereby, this particular may not be the reason that increasing national income leads to increase in imports. This is true only in case of underdeveloped countries where the domestic goods and services are not qualitative. In next slide, we find the fourth cause for disequilibrium in the balance of payment, that is speculative transfer of funds. When funds move from one country to another country, that will bring disequilibrium in the balance of payment. If funds are moving from our country to foreign countries, then it will affect that, then it will lead to increase in debit, and that leads to deficit in the balance of payment. We'll read it for you. The speculative transfer of funds from one country to another country may also bring about a change in the balance of payment position. Movement of capital from one country to another country will definitely influence the equilibrium of the balance of payment. When there are opportunities to earn higher interest or profits in other countries, speculative transfer of funds may take place, and that leads to increase in capital outflow, and it leads to increase in debit in capital account of balance of payment. We have one simple example. If UK announces attractive investment policies, what will be the impact of this? There are likely chances the investment from India will move to UK. If UK says that if a particular amount of investment is made in UK, after some years you will get the citizenship of UK. If this kind of investment policies are announced by UK, then there are many chances the investment from India will move to UK, and that leads to increase in payments from Indian side, and that leads to deficit in the balance of payment. When investment is moving from India to UK, our debits are continuously increasing, and that causes deficit in the balance of payment, which is a kind of disequilibrium in the balance of payment. In addition to this, we have another factor which causes disequilibrium in the balance of payment, and that is changes of foreign exchange rates. A change in the rate of exchange also affects the position of balance of payment of a country. Imports of the country will increase and exports will decrease when the external value of the currency is appreciated, and vice versa. If our currency is appreciated, what will be the impact of this on the balance of payment? This particular situation we are trying to explain with the help of an example. We have taken example of exchange rate appreciation. It means if value of Indian rupees increase in terms of US dollars, thereby US dollars will be cheaper and Indian currency becomes costlier, that is dearer to the foreigners. Thus Indians will have more of US dollars and buy US goods. This leads to payments are more than receipts. In this example, I have taken the exchange rate between American dollars and Indian rupees of two different time periods as shown on your screen. In 2020, $1 was equal to rupees 80. It means we used to pay 80 rupees in order to have $1. But in 2021, $1 is equal to rupees 40. It means with rupees 80, we are able to have $2. This is an example of exchange appreciation. Our currency has become costlier and foreign currency has become cheaper to Indians, and our currency has become costlier to Americans. Under such circumstances, what will happen? Indians will have more of US dollars, and thereby they will buy US goods and services. This leads to increase in imports, and that is nothing but increase in debit. This is how exchange rate appreciation will create deficit in balance of payment of India if the appreciation is in case of Indian rupees. This is how disequilibrium in the balance of payment is influenced and affected by a large number of factors. In this video, we have discussed only 5 important factors which cause disequilibrium in the balance of payment. More and more, we are focused on how deficit in the balance of payment arises because of these factors. With this, we end our discussion on causes for disequilibrium in the balance of payment. In our next video, we shall study what are the remedies to correct disequilibrium in the balance of payment. With this, I end my video lecture.